Here is a step-by-step tutorial on how to create this 3D pencil text effect using Adobe Firefly. Stay tuned and I'll show you how.
Studio Shepherd.
Starting in Adobe Illustrator, we're going to create our text. So select your artboard, set the size to 1920 by 1080 pixels, select the pencil tool, and we're going to draw our calligraphic text. This may take a few tries, so it might help to sketch it out first. But try create your text out of continuous paths. So after some tweaking, this is what mine looks like. Next, we're going to select the rectangle tool, draw out a square, and make sure it's set to fill, and I'm going to give it a gradient. Now open gradient, and I'm going to change the angle to negative 90, so we've got the dark shade on the bottom. Now I'm just going to round the corners, hold Alt and drag to create a copy. Now select the blend tool, click both your shapes to create a blend. Double click the blend tool to bring up these options, and we're going to change spacing to specified steps. Now set this to 1000 and hit enter. So now I'm just going to create a copy and select your shape here as well as each path individually, and then go up to object, down to blend, and select replace spine. Now repeat these steps for each group of paths. And for this path, I want to reverse the direction, so having this looping over top. So to do this, again go up to object, down to blend, and select reverse spine. And so now I'm happy with my text, and so we're going to export this artboard as a JPEG, and then jump across into Adobe Firefly. So in Adobe Firefly, we're going to use this prompt, rubber pencil, bendy, pastel blue with eraser tips, isolated on a light blue studio background, and then click generate. And now adjust the ratio to widescreen 16:9, and scroll down and select hyper realistic. Now click generate again for 4 new options. And we can look at these options, and these are along the right track, and this one here especially, as it has some more detail into the ridging of the pencil. But let's compare it to some other options. So I'm just going to click generate again, and so we've got some new ones here, but these ones still aren't quite right. And so we're going to go back to our first option, and I'm going to go up to edit, and then I'm going to use this as our style reference. So this is going to edit onto our left hand panel, and next we're just going to upload our composition reference. So click this, and we're going to upload our image that we created earlier. So open that, press continue, then click generate, and you should see some options that look like this. So I like the look of these, and when you find one that you like, we're going to hit upscale to create a larger, more high definition image. So this is my favorite, but there's some things I still want to change. So we're going to hit download, and we're going to bring this across to Adobe Photoshop to make some changes. So with our image open in Adobe Photoshop, we're going to start by selecting the pen tool, making a selection around this tip here. We're going to right click and go make selection, press OK. Now in the generative fill bar, we're going to type in the prompt eraser tip and click generate. So we've got some options over here. These aren't quite right, so I'm going to adjust the prompt to say white eraser tip, metal casing, then click generate. So these look a lot better. What we can also do is click for more options and click generate similar. Now I also want to remove this piece of the text as it shouldn't be there, so I'm going to draw a box, right click, make selection, press OK, and type in remove, then click generate. Finally, select the rectangle marquee tool, draw out a rectangle, and we're going to type the prompt semicircle pencil shavings, and then click generate, which is going to create the dot for our eye. and with a few more changes, this is my final design.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to hit that like button and subscribe to stay up to date with the latest design tips. I'll see you in the next video.